what I'm talking about.
Wait.
Okay, now, from the beginning.
Hit it, boys.
अब तो हाथ छोड़ दो मेरा, इतनी भी सुंदर नहीं मैं.
जैसे पान वाला होता है ना, वो ग्राहक देखकर भी खुश हुआ. Then I heard about you and you achieved so much. I feel very very happy to get back in touch and to have spoken with you over here.
Love or lust?
It's an obvious answer. I mean, just imagine me saying lust over here. I couldn't believe you asked me that, but it's good. पता नहीं किस किस कोने में घुस गए मेरे टमाटर.
बट ये फिल्म ही नहीं था.
I really enjoyed talking to you, Geetika.
I love romance.
You are a romantic.
क्या आप सिनेमा के दीवाने हैं? मैं हूँ. सिनेमा में एक ऐसा जादू है जो आपकी रूह को छूकर आपके जहन का हिस्सा बनने की क्षमता रखता है. पर हर फिल्म में ये जादू नहीं होता. हर कोई चलचित्र का कलाकार नहीं होता. कुछ होते हैं, थैंक गॉड फॉर दैट. और उनमें से एक नाम है इनका, जिनसे मैं आज गुफ्तगू करने जा रही हूं. वैसे तो मैं अपनी फेवरेट हूं, पर ये मेरे फेवरेट डायरेक्टर है. व्हाई? बिकॉज ही कैन टेल अ स्टोरी, बिकॉज ही कैन ड्रॉ यू इनटू अ स्टोरी, because he can make you a part of the story, and most magically because he can make that story a part of you. Inki har film ke sath ek rishta hai mera. I cannot describe in words the love that I have for his cinema. Jo bhi main kehna chahu barbaad kare alfaz mere. Films like Socha Na Tha, Aahista Aahista, Jab We Met, Highway, Tamasha, Rockstar, Jab Harry Met Sajal, Love Ajmal 2, the web series She, and many more. His work has received both adoration and detestation. But no one can dispute the fact that he is a master filmmaker. And that is why, in the honor of his masterful filmmaking, today I would like to dress up like Geet from Jab We Met, my favorite character that he's ever created. Everybody, बहुत मजा आने वाला है. Because today I'm talking to Imtiaz Ali. Hello, Imtiaz.
Hello, Geetika. Thank you so much. When we were talking about me, I was filled with this feeling that I wish in this lifetime I could become this, and I will try my best.
No. I think whatever I said, every word was correct. But उससे पहले मैं छोटा सा stunt करना चाहती हूँ. I want to shake hands with you. तो अब मैं कहना चाहती हूँ, अब तो हाथ छोड़ दो मेरा, इतनी भी सुंदर नहीं मैं. You know, I've been wanting to do this all my life, and imagine I'm saying this to the very man who wrote these dialogues. First of all, belated happy birthday. Yeah.
Thank you.
And. Happy National Reading Day, because today is National Reading Day, and I know you read a lot, so happy National Reading
Day. Thank you. Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't read that anywhere, though. But thank you for telling me.
So good. I kind of told you something new today that you don't know, which is a...
It is lots.
No, but that doesn't seem like it when I see your films. Achha, maine aapse jo pehla sawal puchhi, ye bahut predictable hai. Your next film, is it going to be a love story based in the lockdown?
Oh no. I've decided not to make a story on the lockdown, because I have a feeling that once the lockdown is over and we start making films, many of those films are going to be on lockdown.
Well-known building in Jamshedpur where they had 3 cinema theaters, 2 of which were attached to the house. So I would go and, you know, hear the sound of cinema in the background, and since we lived there, I could go there whenever I wanted to. I was allowed in there very easily, but I made friends with the business and so on. So could you go on and say as to how you used to watch a lot of cinema when you were a child? Now, Quentin Tarantino se kisi ne pucha that, have you gone to film school? And he said, no, I've gone to films. So I'm guessing that you, Imtiaz, too, went to films. How did this love for cinema happen, and what was Imtiaz's story before Socha Na Tha?
So I feel that cinema was... obviously, for me, the most fascinating departure from regular life. And to be, it did not even matter what film was playing, whether it was a good film or a bad film. Those things never came to my mind. What came to my mind is the opportunity of getting into that huge dark hall where there would be so many people and there would be the smell of pan. And they used to smoke bidi also those days inside cinema theaters. But it was a dark hall. Everyone was united in being entertained by the things that were coming out from the screen. The large face of the hero, the large face of the heroine, the romance, the sound. It was a very fascinating world. But it was, you know, there are some impossible dreams that you have. And this was an impossible dream. I think I never tried for it, but I got steered towards doing theater. One of them was the fact that I never got into advertising. Like, I didn't get a job in advertising. And then I had to take up a job in ZTV as a kind of a glorified, like, delivery boy. But I was a production assistant, yes. And then I was taking tapes from one to the other studio, etc. And then I had taken over from Ravi Rai, who used to direct earlier. But then unka kuch Anupam Kher ke saath, I think kuch anban ho gayi thi, he walked out or something had happened. I don't want to second guess, actually. But Anupam Kher, who was the producer, said to me that arey yaar tu matlab ye kar lo, and I did it.
So when was that point in Tejas where you thought that, or where you realized that, yes, I want to pursue a career, or in your case it will be I want to pursue a life in filmmaking? When did that happen?
I think when it happened at the time that I actually got into the media world, so to speak. When I started working in ZTV, I realized that I already have a profession and I was enjoying it. And then I thought that now, like, I don't know whether I got this thought, but retrospectively, when I look back at that time, I feel that that's the time I realized that now I'm going to be here.
Let me sort this out for you. So this was just destiny pushing you towards filmmaking with these series of accidents. It's so clear from the story what you're doing.
I do believe that. I feel that one should not get very distracted by these small accidents that happen, because you, in your intelligence, can only plan things to a certain extent. Yeah. Your accidents sometimes become the bigger reason for you to achieve things in your life.
Yes, yes. Now, for the benefits of students watching us, can you suggest to them the choice between assist on a film, go to a film school, or do both?
I feel that, I have done neither. I'm really the wrong person to give this advice. Now, there are many institutes and I do not run them down. I don't say that don't go to film school. Like Quentin Tarantino, maybe it's an unfortunate thing, did not go to film school, I went to films. But now that film schools are there, I will encourage people to give that a thought. When you want, you can also assist, you do anything that you get, you know.
Okay.
Chances are, with young students, Gitika, they will not get the option of either or.
Yes, that's true.
My thing is that if you get something, if you're interested in it, do it.
Yes.
Don't wait for the next thing to come. Till the next thing comes along, do what you're getting. That's what I can tell them.
I'm still going to ask questions related to students here. So quickly, if you can describe a career as a director in filmmaking. And when you're sort of giving us this answer, can you please encompass the human aspect, the business aspect, and the creative aspect, all three of them?
Yeah, so I think, my job is basically as a director. Not as a writer, which I also am, but as a director, my job will always be to show the way, to have the vision, to have a picture in my mind. Yeah. I have to imagine. And that imagination has to be brought alive by various other people as instructed by me. So there is something called vision. That is something that I, as a director, am responsible for. जैसे पान वाला होता है ना, वो ग्राहक देख कर भी पुड़िया बांधता है, which really means that you can't deal with any two people in the same way.
Yes.
You have to talk to them in a way that they understand, and why is it so important that they understand? For your own selfish reason, that they do good work in your film. If you close your eyes, no, मैं कह रहा हूँ, लोगों को लगता बड़ा मुश्किल है, मगर आप अगर सिर्फ अपनी आंखें बंद करें और आपको कोई कुछ कहे या आप खुद कोई मंजर इमेजिन करें, यू विल बी एबल टू गुड और बैड, बट यू विल बी एबल टू दैट देयर इज एक पहाड़ है, उसके नीचे नहर बह रही है, उसके बगल में एक छोटा सा झोपड़ा है और उससे एक लड़की निकलती है और बाहर आकर के, सो दिस सम विजुअल विल हैपन, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल इन एनी ह्यूमन माइंड दैट अ विजुअल डजंट हैपन, टू जस्ट फोकस इन ऑन टू दिस विजुअल इज क्रिएटिविटी, देयर इज नथिंग मोर टू इट, यू नो दिस इज वेयर द फर्स्ट स्टेप टुवर्ड्स क्रिएटिविटी बिगिंस. आप कह रही थी कोई थर्ड एस्पेक्ट कौन सा होता है, बिजनेस
एस्पेक्ट.
सो बिजनेस एस्पेक्ट इज सिंपल मैम, आपको कोई पैसे देता है जो कि प्रोड्यूसर होता है और वो पैसे भी नहीं देता, वो कहता है कि आप जो फिल्म बना रहे हैं, एज अ डायरेक्टर आई थिंक इन इंडिया डायरेक्टर्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द अमाउंट ऑफ यू नो risk that the producer is taking monetarily on you, and you just have to make sure that you get that money back.
I'm going to move on quickly to the next part of our chat, which is the craft of filmmaking, and here is where I start having more fun. My first question to you is, what is your process of creating a film? Like, how do you create the characters, the scenes, the setting, the dialogue, the music, the lyrics, and how do you then weave it all together so beautifully? What is your process? Tell me.
So it kind of flows from the same source, from a singular source, Deepika. It is basically, it comes into you not because you think it's a story. It's like daydreaming. You imagine something. Now that thing, why you're imagining it, you don't know. You just imagine that there is this person and she is getting onto a train, or there is this guy who is talking to somebody, you know. You don't know why you imagine it. You perhaps imagine it because you see somebody in real life, and then you start thinking, putting your imagination on that. Like, what would have happened after this man went home? Did he tell his wife that he had had this encounter? Was his wife upset by it? All of these things have not happened or have happened, but I don't do it. But I start to imagine on top, you know, like on top of what I usually see. This becomes like an infection in my body that I cannot control. Then it develops on its own. I find myself talking about it to other people. I'm going in on auto rickshaw. I'm like, "Bhai, pata hai, main kal ek aadmi se mila. Aise kisi aadmi se mila nahi hu. Ye mera imagination mein chal raha hai. But usko kyun bolu? Usko main bolta hu." ऐसा हुआ था, उससे मैं बात करना शुरू कर देता हूँ, एंड आई कीप टेलिंग हिम, सो द सेम स्टोरी टू डिफरेंट पीपल एट डिफरेंट टाइम्स, दैट्स हाउ इट हैपेंस, बिकॉज़ आई एम सो ईगर टू से इट और थिंक अबाउट इट एंड एंजॉय इट फॉर माय ओन सेक, एंड देन एट वन डे आई रियलाइज दैट यू नो व्हाट, नाउ आई नीड टू गेट इट आउट, एंड दैट्स व्हेन आई राइट, एंड व्हेन आई राइट इट ऑल कम्स आउट टुगेदर, इट्स नॉट एवर दैट ओके नाउ टुडे आई एम थिंकिंग अबाउट कैरेक्टर्स टू दिस फिल्म. Now I'm thinking about the plot points of this film. Now I'm thinking about the setting or the location of this film. Nothing. It's all together. It's just that one imagination.
As an audience, I must say here that for me, the differentiator with you is your imagination. Ma'am, seriously.
Thank you for that.
I see your imagination going to places where not too many can... take it. And I'm going to ask you a question regarding that. We're going to play you a scene from one of your iconic films, Jab We Met. We quickly play it for you. The iconic scene of Hotel Descent. I'd like you to briefly take us inside the scene. Here comes the scene.
Credit card accept karte ho?
No credit, only cash.
Credit card. Tariff kya?
Huh?
एक दिन का रूम का कितना पैसा लेते हो?
Inside this scene.
Yeah, so let me tell you some things about this scene. So ये जो होटल डिसेंट सीन है, this was supposed to happen in Ratlam, but fact of the matter is the unit never went to Ratlam to shoot. We shot this in Manali.
You never ever went to Ratlam at all to shoot any part.
Ratlam railway station was shot in Kamalistan studio back in Mumbai. Ratlam ki galiya was shot in Manali. Part of Ratlam was shot in Lonavala. Part of Ratlam was shot in Bombay. Ratlam was shot everywhere else, but not in Ratlam. This particular scene was shot in Manali. And the reason it was shot in Manali was because, you know, we had extra time and we didn't know what to do. So we placed this over here. The whole of Jab Bhi Met has been shot like that. We've just been like all over the place. We never knew what we were going to shoot the next day. There was no planning. We were just like getting together and saying, boss, kal ye scene kar lete hain. Kyun kar lete hain? Kyunki kar sakte hain.
Then you should shoot your films like that only. I mean, I can never forget the way he said beauty. He was like, come on. Ek baat bataiye aap mujhe. Cinema mein bahut sara grey hota hai. But मैं ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट से ये कह सकती हूँ कि करीना वॉज गीत एंड गीत वॉज करीना सेजल वॉज अनुष्का अनुष्का वॉज सेजल हाउ डू यू कास्ट फॉर योर फिल्म्स
वेल द थिंग इज दैट करीना फॉर इंस्टेंस वॉज ऑलवेज माय फर्स्ट चॉइस टू प्ले गीत आई वाज आई वांटेड हर टू प्ले गीत बट एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम आफ्टर मैंने सोचा ना था आई वॉज लाइक आई डिडंट नो लाइक आई हैड अप्रोच्ड करीना But we couldn't really work it out. So anyhow, one thing I must tell you, there are a lot of differences between Geet and Kareena.
Achha.
Bahut sare differences.
Yeah.
That's how good she is. Kareena is such a fantastic actor. She makes you believe that she's completely Geet. Fact of the matter is that there are lots of things that are different in her. In fact, most of the things are different. She's then not as talkative. She's very she's exactly. Reserved. She's a reserved girl. She's not so talkative. She won't warm up to any stranger and start talking to them. Not at all. Kareena, you know? Wo nahi karegi. Phir secondly, she'd never been on a train before in her life.
But of course,
So uski jo you know, the way she appears, it seems as though she's been on a train so often.
Yes. Yes.
Her biggest nightmare was, how is she going to do that scene where she has to get off a moving train and get back onto it? If you remember, like, miss the train. Even now, when she messages me, she writes Geet instead of Kareena.
I'm telling you, it is the best character of her entire career. I think she can outdo what she did in Jab Bhi Met as Geet. I have a quick round of quickies coming towards you for the fun of this. Do kare jaldi se.
Ji haan, bilkul.
So choose one: money or appreciation.
Sorry, go on.
Money or appreciation.
Appreciation.
Awards or rewards.
Rewards.
Newcomers or stars.
Newcomers.
Lip-sync songs or non-lip-sync songs?
Lip-sync songs, if possible.
Okay. Social media or no social media?
No social media.
Love or lust?
Laugh or lust?
Lust. Laugh or lust?
Nene, you must call, say this again. I can't get you.
Love or lust?
It's an obvious answer. I mean, just imagine me saying lust over here.
I expect you saying love, considering all these beautiful films that you made.
Yeah, but just to shock and surprise you, I'd like to say lust. No, actually, it is love. I was just played with it. I couldn't believe you asked me that, but it's good.
Haan, I knew. Tabhi pucha mere. अच्छा अगला सवाल मेरा ये है कि लोग कहते हैं कि इम्तियाज कैप्चर्स द फ्लॉज ऑफ हिज कैरेक्टर्स एंड समहाउ मैनेजेस टू मेक देम लाइकेबल हाउ डू यू डू दैट बिकॉज़ इट्स अ फ्लॉ इट गेट्स रियल एंड दैट्स इज अट्रैक्टिव हाउ डू यू मैनेज लाइक अ जय और अ महावीर इन हाईवे
यू नो गीतिका आई हैव ऑलवेज बिलीव्ड दैट इट वाज द राइट टाइम फॉर अ पर्सन लाइक मी टू गेट इनटू द फिल्म इंडस्ट्री बिकॉज़ आई फॉर ऑल द सिनेमा वाचिंग दैट आई हैव डन इन माय लाइफ आई एम नॉट सिनेमा लिटरेट सो टू स्पीक I don't think I've learned much from cinema, about cinema. So I am compelled to make those characters in my film that I've seen in my real life. I've seen people, men and women, having imperfections, having frailties, having negative qualities perhaps for time. She can be silly. She can be immature. She can be emotionally carried away. You know, she might be irresponsible. which she was. You know, all of those things she does.
I think this worked in your favor that you aren't film literate in that sense of
Also works in my what also works in my favor is that, you know, maybe 20 years before I started making films, if I started showing flaws in the characters, maybe people wouldn't have accepted it. But now, at this time, people do accept people because what it gives them is a certain sense of relatability.
I tell the technical team to share an image for you, and after that, I'll ask you my favorite question of today. Okay. Now, you obviously remember the scene, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Whenever I see these 20 seconds of the film, it blows me away. Yeah. Okay? Because she's trying to hug him and he wants to hug her back and she doesn't allow it. And the way Shah Rukh and Anushka have executed this, it's like, I just look at it every time and say, yaar, ye kaise imagine kiya hai? How has he imagined this? Where did this come from? Kaise? How?
So what is happening over here is that this is really the theme of the entire film, this particular shot. So he is somebody who thinks of himself as an inferior for her. He thinks he's a corrupted quantity. He thinks he's a corrupt man. Badnaam aadmi hai, kharab aadmi hai. He's dirty. He feels he's dirty. And he feels that she is so pure that she should be put like a porcelain vase in a showroom and just kept over there, not touched.
Mujhe to badi achhi lagti hai film. And I keep watching it again and again and again and again and again and again. And why didn't it do well, despite being the fact that it was SRK, Imtiaz, Anushka? What went wrong? Because mujhe to kuch problem nahi dikh rahi hai. I can watch it 100 more times.
So, I don't know. Yeah, it didn't do well. People did not like it. Most people disliked the film and when it released. And when that happens, I feel that really the film was not good for them. You know, it's very difficult to say for a maker. Main ye kabhi nahi samajhta ki public ko samajh mein nahi aaye, public bewakoof hai. Maine to badi achhi film banayi thi, but kisi wajah se nahi chali. Aisa nahi hota. For some reason, the audience didn't like it. I accept. Some people liked it, and I'm glad that you did. And but yeah, mostly people didn't like it. Yeah, and there was a certain experiment that I was trying to do here. It was a very, very thin storyline, and Shah Rukh Khan is a very, very big star. So some people have told me that maybe, you know, if the star was not so big, it was just some other person, then it would have had a better chance of being seen for what it is. Maybe that was the reason.
No, I think it was one of his... I've never seen him look more attractive than in this film. Really. Ye samajh nahi aaya mujhe why people didn't want to go in and see that. This scene is also a great example of how you capture scenes and don't construct or create them, which is something I wanted to put out there for the students also. Okay, another quick rapid fire coming your way. If you want, you can answer. Otherwise, if you think I won't say anything, then I'm okay with that. So, favorite film of yours?
Sholay.
No, your own made. Your own
made is very difficult. You can't like your own films, you know. Ultimately, you don't.
I'll go with Sholay. The favorite character you've created?
Jordan.
Okay. Any favorite dialogue of yours that you've written?
मुझे ना जब भी मैट का एक डायलॉग बड़ा वेग से बहुत अच्छा लगता है कहते हैं कि यार सामने सामने से तो मैं भी उठा लूंगी तू कोने कोने से उठा पता नहीं किस किस कोने में घुस गए मेरे टमाटर I somehow like that dialogue a lot.
But ये फिल्म में नहीं था
फिल्म में बैकग्राउंड में एक औरत बोल रही होती है जब
ओ स्टेशन पे
टमाटर वाली होती है वो कह रही होती है पता नहीं किस किस कोने में घुस गए मेरे टमाटर
Somehow
I like that a lot.
Nice, nice. Favorite song of yours?
Phir Se Ud Chala. From my films, right? From my
yes,
films.
Yes, Abhi films too. Okay. And favorite favorite scene of yours, jo aapne create kiya.
I like the scene. I'll say some of the scenes. Okay, one of them is the climactic scene of Veera is on that rock and she's just gets emotional seeing the beauty of that place.
The end. Yeah.
Yeah. So these scenes I can remember off the mind, off the top of my head.
How your favorite scenes of your own films are different from my favorite scenes of your films. I'll later send you a list of the ones that I completely get blown away with.
Why don't you say right now, quickly, if you have the time?
मुझे जब भी मेट से वो ट्रेन का सीन बहुत अच्छा लगता है जब वो बोलती जाती है looking at her and he's like his expressions are changing I can't give you a scene or two here
मुझे but you're a जब भी मेट fan aren't you like जब भी मेट
नहीं इम्तियाज I'm a fan of all your films I love romance मुझे romance से प्यार है And I think I don't find better romance in any director's films other than yours. It's my brand of romance. For me,
what do you think about the romance in Highway, let's say, a film like that?
You know, I like the film very much. And I understand why she loved him. I understand it. But I just wish it had had a different ending.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
You are a romantic.
I didn't want
die hard romantic.
I'm a die hard romantic. Absolutely. Mm. Even and for me I was so relieved that Harry and Sejal finally got married at the end. So you should do another film with Shah Rukh, I'm telling you. You should, yeah. Something set in Kashmir or something. That's really what you also end up making
I'm trying for that.
It happens. And it's also the plus point is the added advantage is that you're also making it look very it's very beautiful. It's very enjoyable for the soul to watch your films. I have one last question for you because I have to let you go because I've exceeded by 15 minutes. All your female characters have a lot of agency in your films, whether it's Amira. A lot of agency.
Why? Because, again, art imitates life. Huh. I have found women around me to have a lot of agency, much more than men, honestly. Okay. Like, I look at my mother or I look at my various friends or even my daughter now. And they have a lot of agency. They are intelligent, they are not banal, they are practical, at the same time creative, at the same time intuitive, at the same time, they can multitask so many things that I can't do. So in admiration of women, I try to make women in my film the same as I see in life.
Okay, I don't want to stop this conversation, but mujhe dande padenge agar main stop nahi karunga. Any last message that you have for everyone who's watching?
Watch a lot of films. Watch different kinds of films. When you watch a film, give it a chance. Do not become the critic. Just remain the audience.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so, I really enjoyed talking to you, Gitika. I must say that there was so much that I'd heard about you and you achieved so much. I feel very, very happy to get back in touch and to have spoken with you over here.
No, I don't deserve your praise. Honestly, genuinely love your films, which is why probably it has come through in this conversation. It may have not been like somebody else.
No, I'm sure that's not the case. I'm sure that you deserve all the accolades that you have received. But thank you very much. I had a great
thank time. Thank you. And I'm going to send you off by playing my favoriteest song from your film, which is this one. It's going to surprise you, the one that I've picked. I'll sing two lines and then they'll put the film on.
Oh yeah, please.
So it goes. Oh yara rab, rus jaane de. Remember?
Yes.
Chut jaane de. Take it on, guys. We love you, Imtiaz Ali.
Thank you.
जाने दे दीवाना जग छुट जाने दे मैं तेरा दिल बनती रहूं